Yeah, he's my brother.
Yes, I'm good to see you here. But when the legend, Percy's been holding us up here.
4613, here, you know, OMB estimates that the delinquent debt is between $35 and $40 billion, and also that this could possibly mean over the next few years, a collection of about $2.5 billion, and I think it's...
We need it.
Oh, and I think it's needed to restore the viability of some of those lending programs. And it's fair, and I thank all of you.
It's our pleasure, Mr. President, that was a good fight.
Well, we're...
Brother, we thank you for the support of this administration. It's just been marvelous to have an idea that picked up so quickly and implemented already. We're now collecting from delinquent positions who have been making $100,000 a year and still haven't paid their student loans off. And the US attorneys are out seizing their sometimes imported automobiles, and they remain business now, but it's not gonna hurt anyone that can't pay, but it certainly is gonna benefit those who have the resources to pay it and just been deadbeating up to this point.
Well, you know, when I was governor, we found out that the University of California, 9 campuses, a great university, the administration offices was actually telling the students as they helped them get government loans that they wouldn't have to pay them back, and telling them how they could avoid it. You know, one of the things they frankly told them, they said, don't, when you get out and get working, don't immediately buy something like a condominium or anything of that kind. And then, as quickly as you can, declare personal bankruptcy before you own anything that would hurt you in being seized, and that wipes out the debt. And they were taught this at school.
Well, there's some feeling that although you pay your other debts, you don't have to pay them if you owe them the federal government.
What?
You might call this an Illinois bill.
Do all the proceeds go to Illinois?
Four out of four from Illinois.
That's your name, that's all I need, I'm...
Just my name?
That's really great.
Looks like this is an Illinois special interest.
That's right.
See, speaking of Illinois, I've got a personal story that's appropriate for the occasion today. That's why the professor is not supposed to read it, and if it was anymore. I had, you know, it used to, you know, there were foundations and so forth. I worked my way through school, and finally, along about the last year, with the cause of me not having, I had to get a loan, I got one in the Henry Strong Foundation. And it was administered by, Great Northern, the bank.
The Northern Trust Company.
Northern Trust.
In Great Northern, the river, in Chicago. Well, Northern Trust had, in the high days of radio, a radio program that was really of a caliber of network shows. And they came to Hollywood and they get guest stars to come in and do a show at the Hollywood Luxury Theater. And it was only over WGN, just one station. And a big formula that you would come in, you would meet, you would be taken to the chairman of the board's office, and you'd meet him and all the board members, and then you'd go rehearse, and then all of the board, their wives, and their friends would form the studio audience as you did the show. Well, I came in, and this little man was sitting behind this big desk, and came in and met him and so forth. He said, "We think we have something here you might be interested in seeing." It was the first time I'd ever been invited from Hollywood to be the guest on the show. Handed me this letter, and I looked, and there in my handwriting was my letter asking for this loan. And I had no, you know, and I looked at it, and I said, "Well, I sure am glad I paid it back." And he said, "Mr. Reagan, if you hadn't paid it back, you wouldn't be here."
That's the message we want to hear.
Of course, the fee for that one radio program was about 6 times more than the loan.
Inflation had something to do with it.
Well, this thing is a revolving fund, and we're trying to put across the point that students who have gotten loans and gotten their education hold back, then it's gonna hurt new students. And 30,000 of them work for the federal government and get a check every twice a month, and they haven't paid their student loans. They had Harper really done tremendous.
I'm convinced that when it's really brought to their attention this way, many will. Because another one, this one goes back to my college days experience also. The fraternity house had a big pileup in those depression days of unpaid bills. Fellows had left college unpaid. And two of us were talking about it, and no one thought anything could be done about it. So at the weekly meeting, the two of us said, okay, will you apply 10% of anything we can collect against our bills in the fraternity house? And we just sat down and by hand wrote letters and said, you know, this, the hardship now for others that have to do this and charge as they did, and the strapped house, strapped the fraternity was for all of this. And you'd be surprised. We had a hell of a collection rate, about an 80% collection rate, just from those single letters to each one of them. And it sure did help pay our bills.
President, we want to thank you for having us at Winsky announce the statement for it.